All right, some of my subscribers have been asking me about croakers because we're getting into summertime. Croakers become more accessible. People use them a lot. The marinas have them, and it just having those baits really helps out a lot on big trout and big redfish. So I have a regular size croaker right here. He's about, I don't know, maybe 3 inches long. We get them all different sizes, but this is probably about average size that most people get. And y'all wanted to know, how do you hook these? And there's different ways you can do it. I'm going to show you a couple ways. My favorite way, I have a kale hook here, and I have what I call just a, it's just a bait hook. It's a live bait hook, they call it. I like this hook because it's really stout when I'm using croakers, but I'll use a kale also. I don't ever hook croakers on a treble hook. I just find that they fall off all the time. The hook is too thin, and there's not a lot of area for that hook to go through, so I just don't use them. But let's just use the kale hook, right? So there's a couple places you can hook them. First of all, you can hook them you can hook the croaker in the nose, and you'll hear people say it. But right here behind the eyes, this is where their brain is. So what we want to do is when we go into the croaker, you see the side of his mouth right here where the end of the inside of the mouth is? If you take your hook and always go to that corner and then just come straight up through the nose, it will hang just like this. That croaker can swim freely. He will go all over the place. And remember, predators hit from the head first. So what's going to happen is that trout or that redfish is going to eat it this way. So when you feel that tap and that hit, when you pull, you're going to hook that fish right there in the corner of the mouth. You'll get them every time. It's a great way to hook them, but that's one way, okay? We're hooking through the nose. The second way that you can hook them is through the back. A lot of people do this also. I do this normally through the back when I have big croakers, like really, really big ones, and I'm fishing offshore for big bull reds or sharks. I'll use a bigger hook, of course, but you could do this also with trout. You see the top of the dorsal fin where it meets right here on the back. That's the meatiest part of the fish. What I always do is go down about a quarter of an inch, come through where it's sitting, where I have enough room where my fish can catch the point. I don't want to go down into the fish because the point will be embedded into the fish. And you'll never catch the predator that you're trying to get. But if you do this, he can now, and I like to do it this way when I'm fishing under cork. I like to use through the nose if I'm fishing Carolina rig or if I'm fishing on bottom with a jig head. I like to do it with the nose. But this way, I love to do it a cork because then that croaker, he swims. He can take this and swim all around underneath the cork, looking natural. And when a fish comes up and hits him head first, you get that hook every single time, okay? Now, I have had people fish with me and they tell me they hook them way back here in the back of the fish and come out like this, okay? I can understand that that may work. I don't do it, but there's no skin there. So, like, if you set the hook or you're popping a cork, it's going to come right out because there's no meat there for that fish. See, that hook came right out. If you put it up here where the meat is, up here, when you pull on that, you don't lose that fish that easily. So croaker fishing is a productive way to catch really big fish. We normally use them when the bigger trout start showing up and the big bulls, the sharks, the big jacks, all of those things. We use croakers for them, and they produce great, and they work really well when you're fishing deeper water. So if you get a croaker, try that those ways of hooking them, and I hope that'll help you out catching more fish when you do use croakers. Now make sure you subscribe below, and please leave a comment. If you have any questions, I'll go over everything again, okay? I'll see y'all out on the water.